so glad to meet you. I'm so sorry that not only that you're having to deal with this now, but that you've dealt with this your whole life. What was this like growing up as a child? This had to be just terrible.
It brings on an enormous amount of shame. And it makes it really hard to get close to people when you can't have friends over for play dates.
Right.
There's just, you know, when you grow up in a home that smells, it permeates into your clothes, and I get...
Into your hair, your skin, everything, right?
Yeah. So it's like I grew up not, like, letting people get physically close to me.
Did kids tease you about that?
I don't recall being teased. I just remember reactions where people would be like, what is that smell? And I would just sink because I knew it was me.
I understand that she has been evicted legally. Yes. I mean, they've gone through the process. Mm-hmm. So the sheriff has served, and she's being evicted in just a matter of, well, at this point, it can be any minute, right?
The sheriffs are any minute going to post a 5-day notice to move. Yes.
That's any minute. I mean, she could, because there's a lot of stuff there. Does she have any plan of where to go?
She was thinking maybe stay in a hotel for a while.
And what are you going to do with the animals? What's the plan for the animals?
That is a huge source of frustration for me, because to me it's not about the animals. And there's been a lot of focus on the perfect home for them. And to me, I'm like, really? Anything's going to be an improvement?
Well, yes. I mean, these dogs are living... This is unsanitary for dogs, let alone for your mother.
It's a dog kennel, and it's not clean enough for a dog. I agree.
Yeah, seriously, if ASPCA sees this, and they will, they'll have a real problem with these dogs, because this dog has a broken foot.
I know. I saw that for the first time when I went in with you guys.
That dog has a broken foot. That was the first thing. I'm a big animal advocate. This dog has a broken foot, and it's not being attended to.
Right.
So that can create a problem and get gangrenous, and that dog can die. I mean, this is animal abuse is what she's doing. This isn't, she's not rescuing these animals. This is an abuse situation.
And that's why I'm here, because I have felt so much, you know, of a need to do something, and it's really hard to know what to do and how to do it and at what, where to begin with all of this, but I know something needs to be done. Yeah.